Today we'll see these two problems. In first problem, the given data, instead of writing a complete statement, I have just written here the given data. Okay. In this, the line AB, 75 millimeter long, it is given. Now the end point A, 20 millimeter above HP, 20 millimeter above HP, 60 millimeter in front of VP. Point B, 60 millimeter above HP, and the point end point B, 10 millimeter in front of VP. Along with that, the top view of line inclined to VP, top view of line inclined to VP, 45 degree. It means which angle? Apart from this theta, phi, alpha, as the top view of line or the plan of line is inclined, means this angle is nothing but beta. Means the beta is given, endpoint conditions have been given above in, with respect to HP and VP, and line AB 75 millimeter long given. It indicates the true length of line. So following things are unknown. Okay, we'll try to solve this problem with the given information. Okay, so let's start with the xy line first. So this one is the xy line. As usual, as I suggested you, draw one line close to x, from where you may take end point A, 20 millimeter above HP. So I will take 20 millimeter above HP. This is, I say it's a dash. Then end point A, 60 millimeter. I will take this point A, 60 millimeter. This is what, and this distance is 60. This is 60, this one is 20, I will be taking this 20. Okay. Immediately, I will draw line passing through this. I will draw it horizontal. Then, we cannot use this 75 degree, but here the end point B, we can take end point B 60 millimeter above HP, means from here we will take it 60 millimeter. We will take this 60 millimeter. This is nothing but 60. So we say it's a locus of line A. I say it's a 60 millimeter. We say locus of B. Means your B dash and B1 dash point will appear on this line. Then end point B is also 10 millimeter in front of VP. So from XY line, below XY line, at a distance of 10 millimeter, this distance is 10 millimeter. So this is the locus of B again. So on this, the A point, A dash point, and locus of B. So means we have used this information. The next is beta. So beta always it goes through point A. Okay. Now we will be drawing the 45 degree in this direction, because this B point is just 10 millimeter in front of VP. So from this point, we will draw a line at an angle of 45 degree. So we will take this 45 degree. This angle is 45 degree. So this will give you the point B. And this is nothing but your top view. You will get the top view on drawing this 45 degree. You will get point where it cuts to this locus of point B. Now this is what you can achieve by using this information. This angle is beta angle. Okay. This angle is beta. Okay. Now the next, you can straight away you will get B dash point, but as usual procedure you follow, and by taking through this point you will be taking arc from B, you will take draw arc, and then from here you will be going up where it's cut to this point, it will be the point B1 dash. Actually you need not require this. So here straight away you join this A dash with B1 dash. It will give the true length, and this angle will be the theta angle. Then either you, now once you come to know this distance, okay, another option with you is that you can go straight away upward where it cuts to this line, draw a line and here you will get the B dash point, and this angle becomes alpha. Now this is the true length. Now this is your front view. A dash B dash will be the front view. Now you know very well this distance. Otherwise from here you draw an arc with A dash as a center, draw arc, then from here straight away you will go down, and this will give the B2 point. Join this line with B2, you will get the true length, and this angle will be phi angle. Okay. So in this way you will get the true length front view, true length top view. Okay. You will get these angles, and the important thing which you need to understand from here is that whatever the distance between this is called as a end projector distance. It means A dash A with the point, then B dash and B. This distance between B dash B and A dash A, it is termed as end projector distance. This is called as a end projector distance. The distance between A dash and A line and the B dash and B line is nothing but the end projector distance. So here you can also measure the end projector distance. So whatever the unknown, finally you have to write all the distance. You know that this is going to give the EL. This is what the phi L. This distance is nothing but phi L. So in this way you can solve this problem.